News Radio 700 WLW.
So, Rock, you're working from home. Should your boss be able to do a pop-by just to make sure you ain't sitting there day-drinking and playing video games?
Now, this is one of those things where I could see both sides of it. On one side, you'd say, that's ridiculous. You can't show up to my home. But on the other hand, the boss could say, well, technically, yes, while you're at home, you are on the clock right now. You are at work, even though you're sitting in your own home. So I could, just as if I would, during the course of the day, walk past your cubicle and check in on you, see how it's going, see how you're meeting your quota, see what is on your computer. I should be able to do the same thing when you're at your own home.
Well, let's talk to an expert in these matters, our good friend Spencer O'Leary. He's the CEO of ActiveOps North America. They're a global company that's a leader in management process automation that helps people kind of keep track of what's going on in remote locations. Spencer, how are you?
Hi, I'm good, thanks. How are you both?
We're doing great. So, good. Spencer, as a manager, your thoughts on this? Would you take it upon yourself to do a pop by just to see what John was doing today?
You know, personally, I would not, but I see a lot of managers who are trying to be in control, and there's appropriate ways of trying to be in control of your workforce, and then there's some inappropriate ways of trying to be in control. And I think this statement here around managers popping by someone's house and calling in unannounced, it crosses the line. It goes into that inappropriate way of managing to try and feel in control. We see other technology on the market where people can take a snapshot picture through a laptop's webcam to make sure that the person sat in front of the machine. Again, for me, that crosses the line and goes into an inappropriate way of controlling. There's plenty of technology out there in the world. We provided at ActiveOps that helps managers know, as one of you just talked about, it's like walking past the cubicle. We can help organizations see that digitally. Who's doing what? Who's on what screens? Have people fulfill their quota? Are people being productive? You don't need to call past someone's home unannounced to find that out.
Now, I see what you're saying, but I think there would be some that would argue, well, I'd rather have the boss maybe check in on me at my house at once every 2 weeks than have every single keystroke on my computer monitored, every single website I go to. I mean the combined time that you're under surveillance would be much, much longer doing that versus, okay, every once in a while the boss may stop by and check in and see what you're doing.
Yeah, and I think those announced visits from a boss at home are great for people who work at home full time. It's nice to see your boss now and again and maybe have a bi-weekly or a monthly check-in and one-to-one. But let's not kid ourselves with what data is already available. Any IT department for any organization, if you're using a Windows-based operating system machine, laptop or desktop, if an organization wanted to see every keystroke that's conducted and done by an employee, they can look at that data today. The important thing is taking that raw data and turning it into useful information for managers to better manage their employees, better manage their production, better manage their well-being, even today, better managing their office eligibility, whether they can work from home or the office. That type of data collected, and most importantly, used in the right way, and that's what we do at ActiveOps. We're helping businesses and managers use this data in the right way. It can be a real positive experience for the employee, for the employer. It still requires some human contact now and again, but getting that into the right framework is a really important thing for businesses to do.
Spencer O'Leary is our guest. And Spencer, I brought this up a while back to another guest we had talking about this very same topic. It seems to me, if you do something like this, you're expressing a real lack of trust, which would offend the hell out of me as your employee. No?
Absolutely right. And, you know, there's a labor shortage across the U.S. at the moment, and people will vote with their feet. And if bosses start calling around unannounced to check that people aren't goofing off, you know, that employee will vote with their feet. They'll go work for somebody who has a more appropriate way of measuring and managing their production and their well-being. So invest in the right technology to enable you to do this stuff remotely. Don't cross the line and do things that are unannounced and spy on people. Also, don't cross the line and measure and monitor every single keystroke. Again, it's not an appropriate way to manage people. Trust them. Make sure you've got good data about their performance and their well-being, and you will have a really positive hybrid workforce, whether they're working from the home, whether they're working from the office, or anywhere in between. The right thing to do for employees and employers.
I mean, you are right. I mean, we live in a world now where the employee has a ton of power, I mean, compared to even 2 years ago, right? Because you're right, because, I mean, the workforce is desperately looking for people to work. They're paying them crazy wages. I mean, here in town, I mean, if you, you know, you sign up to be a nurse, you get a $40,000 signing bonus. I mean, these, you know, they're paying college tuition to fast food workers, that kind of thing. So I guess, yeah, you can kind of be a little bit pickier and make some demands now these days with how the situation is.
Yeah, as you say, the power is with the employee, not the employer at this point in time. And, you know, most people want to go to work, whether that's from their home office or from a physical business office. They want to go and do a good day's work for a good day's pay. And anyone who's got that mindset, they don't mind being measured and monitored at an appropriate level to make sure that their production, their quota attainment, and their well-being is at a good level. And any employee that's not of that mind and wants to hide and wants to goof off, you know, it doesn't matter whether you put software to monitor them on their desktop, you monitor every keystroke, or you call by their house. If employees are of that mindset, they're going to do it anyway. The important thing for me is that we find appropriate management technology and techniques. We train our managers in the right way of how to use this technology and this data so that they can make sure they stay the right side of that gray line, be in the appropriate way of managing. As I say, we get that right. I think we've got a really positive experience in a hybrid world for both employee and employer.
Excellent. Spencer O'Leary, thanks so much for your time.
Thanks. Nice to speak to you both.